Hi, and welcome back to the final segment of our Star Trek special for October. Marina Sirtis sitting next to me. It's such a pleasure to have you here.
Well, you know, I was just thinking how time flies when you're enjoying yourself.
That's
it seems
true.
Like I've been sitting here for 10 minutes.
It's true. Well, we have something that comes from the manufacturers exclusive to you. Now, you can go to a StarCon and pick up a pin very similar to this, but it has Live Long and Prosper in words across the bottom, and it's real thin foil. This is solid gold tone metal. It is really heavy. It is the Live Long and Prosper pin for only $17.48. It is nearing the end of its life as an introductory price. It'll go up to $19.25 very soon. Good line from Spock, of course. Actually, about a 4,000-year-old symbol of the rabbis as they bless the congregations. That's what
really?
That's what that's from. It's actually about 4,000 years old.
I didn't know that. See, yeah, I'm learning more about Star Trek today from you, Bob, than I knew before.
Well,
I
learned that from a viewer. Somebody wrote in and told me this whole story. It's available to you now, $17.48. It's one of our most popular pins because it doesn't say anything. It's just a feeling. And it's one of the great feelings. I mean, I like that.
Greeting.
Call it a greeting, but it's a farewell greeting. Live long and prosper.
Yeah. It's actually something that, even though we don't use it on the Next Generation, the fans use it to us. People say to me, live long and prosper. And it's one of the nicest things you can say to anybody, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, don't ask me to do that, though, because I have to really think about it.
It takes a while. Oh, we have to let you know, we have sold out completely of that soundboard pin. It is sold out completely. We'll try and get more for you. Thanks for your calls on it. We are having another Star Trek special November 10th. That's a Tuesday, and it'll be in the evening. I don't know the exact time just yet. William Shatner will be our guest. We can announce that today. Captain Kirk will be our guest at that point. We'll try and get more of those pins. If there's anything you could do in the acting field right now, what do you think it would be? Is there anything you really have a hankering to do?
Well, there's the kind of theatrical part of me that still, and will always. I want
to be on the boards.
I want to be in a successful play on Broadway, and I'd like to be to act at the Royal Shakespeare Company at Stratford upon Avon in England, and they're my two dreams still.
Do you and Patrick Stewart ever fall back into Shakespearean?
He does. He does. He did a lot more Shakespeare than I did. I only did two Shakespeare plays. I played Ophelia in Hamlet, and I actually played the boy in Henry V.
Oh, no kidding.
At drama school, you know, where they give you a chance to do everything. So I was the boy in Henry V. But in a professional capacity, I was Ophelia in Hamlet.
You were also Esmeralda in The Hunchback.
I was Esmeralda in The Hunchback of Notre Dame. But, or Notre Dame, as you call it in America. Patrick, though, not only has played he makes jokes about himself saying that every time they needed a low comic, he got the part at the Royal Shakespeare Company. That isn't true. He played some very high parts also. But he remembers the dialogue. He remembers whole chunks of Shakespeare and often
just flops into it.
In his ready room as Captain Picard, which is a tribute to, I think, to Patrick Stewart, there is a compendium of Shakespeare, complete works, open in the case.
It pops up every once in a while, too. We saw a lot of it in Star Trek VI, but there was an episode where Picard was trading. It was with Q. They were trading Shakespearean.
That's right. The thing is, I think the reason they do that is because Shakespeare is timeless. It will always be around. It's been around for all these hundreds of years, and it'll be around for the next hundreds of years, too.
Especially if you live long. We're going to stop for 60 seconds on this, just for a moment.
Okay.
This is almost completely sold out. It's How to Host a Mystery. I've done one of these at home. It was a murder for me.
Murder parties, yeah.
Yeah, they're wonderful, aren't they? And this one, you get to solve a Star Trek mystery by being any one of your favorite people. You can be Commander Will Riker. Now, there are four men, four women. Commander William Riker, Dr. Beverly Crusher, Lieutenant Commander Data, Counselor Deanna Troi, Lieutenant Worf, Ensign Ro Laren, who is a recent addition to the crew, really,
Lieutenant
Commander Geordi LaForge, and Guinan.
Uh-huh.
You will be one of these folks. You will get, actually somebody will mail you, one of these little books. And each one of these little books, let me just pull this one out here. Here's Guinan.
And you read up on your character.
You read up on your character. They give you a little bit of information about what you're supposed to know and what you're supposed to reveal and not reveal. The actual story here is that around Delphi 4, They have found the orb of knowledge, which will give you complete, it'll answer any question you ask it of any time frame on any subject completely correctly and honestly. So it's very bad if it falls into the wrong hands, and the Romulans are after it too. Well, Captain Picard has it, puts it, you read some of the things in there, puts it into the Starship Enterprise, and someone steals it, and you, as one of the eight characters from Star Trek The Next Generation, will solve the mystery. It takes about 3 hours. They even give you recipes for a dinner, to have a dinner party.
That's right.
And it is just wonderful. What were you laughing about?
I was laughing at, it says here, you left Will's quarters at 7 this morning. What was Deanna doing in Will's quarters at 700 hours in the morning? That's what I want to know.
And you have all of that given to you, and you play off of each other. Now, we've both done murder mysteries, and they're just, especially if you have any actor's blood in you at all, it is a lot of fun because you get the situation, but then you get to improv all the dialogue.
That's exactly. And you have to know your character. You really do have to know your character.
Yes, indeed. 3550, it's almost gone, T3202.
Right, because it shows actually the side of Jonathan that we love, because he is one of the nicest human beings you'll ever meet.
Yeah.
And he's so happy. He's such a happy person. And Riker sometimes is a little bit
edgy.
It's nice to see him smiling.
If you would like to have a medal, if you would like to be a decorated member of the USS Enterprise, here it is. This is the USS Enterprise pin, but it is a medal. It has the bar with USS Enterprise across the front, and then it has the charm that dangles from the bar. And you can wear that on a jacket, as a jacket medal or a pin. It's only $17.86, marked down from $19.75.
I'm going to get that for my father-in-law, because he was a colonel in the Air Force.
Oh,
and
be great.
I think he's been through some surgery recently, and I think he deserves a medal. So
well,
I'm
going to
get this for you, Joe, okay?
And J16135, please mention that when you call. Your folks were, actually, we share one little bit of history. I was going against my folks' wishes, too. I was to be a doctor.
Oh.
That was it.
I was to be a lawyer.
All right. We were supposed to be professional people in that ilk, and entertainment was what I wanted to do, and same with you.
Mm-hmm.
I eventually made peace with both of my parents, as did you.
Well, I made peace with my father. Unfortunately, passed away before Star Trek.
Sorry.
But I think he knows.
He knows.
I think so.
But let me ask you a question about that. When you are with the character of Lwaxana Troi, is there a little bit of your parents woven into that?
Well, I often say that my reaction to Lwaxana on Star Trek is the same as my reaction to my own mother in real life. They're very different people. They're totally different people, but it's just a mother and daughter thing that I don't think I have to explain to people in the audience. I love my mom to death, don't get me wrong. She's a great, great lady, and Lwaxana is a great, great lady. It's just that there's a lot of issues that come up between mothers and daughters.
Right.
As you know, I get on much better with my mom. Now we're living in different countries.
Let's go draw the next lucky number on that note, and Steve will do the honors for you.